Hi, I'm Pradeep, and in this video, in next couple of minutes, you are going to learn how to build better search experience for your users using neural search. I consider myself as an average developer, and by average developer, I mean when you ask me to build a search in my application, this is what I build. If I am building a search system for Adidas and someone is searching Adidas trouser, but they have made some spelling mistakes, this is what I show them. No results found. But do you think this should be the result for such spelling mistake? I don't think so. Because that's not what I expect when I go to some popular search engines or when I go to some e-commerce store. That's a really poor experience that we are designing for. So how can we make it better? And that is where we are going to learn about how neural search can help us do that. So a better search experience would have been something like this. If I had made a mistake, still, this search engine would have showed me the results which matched exactly what I was searching for, Adidas trouser. So it fixes my spelling mistake and shows me the results. Now, before learning about neural search, let's go to how people have been implementing search system starting from 1950s. So I'm quickly going to give you an overview of three different approaches that have been followed till now. So it started with rules. Simply people started building rules for implementing their search system. And that's what I have done when I wanted to build search for my database in MongoDB or Postgres or any other database that I had. I simply put some rules. I match the first keyword. What is the first keyword? You show me results matching that first letter, and then maybe second letter, and then so on. So that is rules based approach. And although I applied some domain knowledge that I had, that this might be the one result which people will be most interested in, and then applied some more logic to that. But in the end, all of that was rules. And this is exactly what has been the primary way of building search system based on rules. Started in 1950s and was almost the only thing that you could do till 90s. And after 90s up to 2010, statistics has been another second approach to make search smart, make search more effective, and that applies the learning on data. You use statistics and machine learning to understand features of your data, and when someone queries in that data, you match the correct result based on those features and parameters that you learned about. So if you know about machine learning, it works on examples. You train it with some examples where you say this is the input, this is the output, and you also tell that this is these are the features which might affect my output, which might affect my search result in our use case. So that is the second approach, statistics, which improved lots of shortcomings of rules-based approach. And the latest one we are going to talk about is neural networks. How do you implement search system using neural network? And that's this approach covers shortcomings of statistics approach. And this is more or less machine learning. This is machine learning is only, but using neural network. So if you don't know about neural network, how neural network works is that you you train your neural network, your model, based on some inputs and then outputs, And then it learns on its own what should be the feature, what should be the parameters. And based on that, when you give another some results, some queries, then based on that, it will try to predict what should be the right result. Comparing with the earlier approach, machine learning approach, with this latest one, neural network. In machine learning, usually when we are talking about not neural network, then we are talking about that we are also giving features. We are also giving data about the parameters. But in neural networks, we are not giving that. We are simply saying input and output. And it's the job of the neural network to figure out what parameters, what features should be there for me to predict the results accurately. So if you want to refresh your memory about neural networks, or if even if you don't know about neural networks, this is a quick slide to show you that how it works. So first, as I said, it works on input and output. So input, let's say we are going to search and database of image, and then we are going to figure out whether this is an image of a cat or an image of dog. Okay, so now we have given lots of data to it, cat images, dog images, and then we have also given the output that this is the dog, this is a cat, and so on. So now you see this layer in the between, it's hidden layer. So these are the parameters which are defining a particular object, a particular image, as a cat or as a dog. If it had been a normal machine learning, we would have given those parameters, we would have given those kind of functions. But in neural networks, it's what neural network does. It figures out that what parameters or what type of functions do I use to predict the output accurately. So you train based on lots of images, lots of data of dogs and cats. And eventually, when you give it a new image, it will be able to accurately predict whether this is a cat or a dog. Now, thanks to neural network, we get new capabilities in search. And when we use neural network for search system, we call that simply neural search. So what new capabilities do we get using neural search or neural networks? One of them is semantic search. As we were discussing, that we can fix those spelling mistakes, we can still return relevant results based on those queries which are not exactly the match of our keyword. So it could be the spelling mistake, it could be some concept related to that particular keyword that we are typing in. So that is what we call semantic search. So using neural search, we get this semantic search capability. We also get capabilities to search between different data types. So you can type a query to search images, and we can type text to search videos. We can show it some images, and then can get search the database of videos, or maybe text, and mix and match. So this is a capability which is possible using neural networks, searching across different data types. Then we can also use multiple data types, such as when we are giving a query to the search system, we can say that this is the image and some text, let's say. So image plus text, and then we are getting some results. So let's say for this example, we are getting image results. So I'm giving this search system a length of a skirt, and then I'm saying that replace this with 3/4 of this length. So two data types, image plus text, and then it is showing me results of those skirts which match this criteria. So that is what another capability that we get using neural network or neural search. A quick summary about evolution of search. you must remember Yahoo. So this was the first one which started catalog based search, where they would index the data on web from different websites. They'll categorize it in different categories, label it, and then when someone queries Yahoo, someone searches on Yahoo, they will filter down those categories and then give the relevant result. Heavily human based approach, everything is done by humans, entering these labels and everything, categories. So that was the first system. So that was a rules based system only. And then we saw some improvement. We saw projects like Elasticsearch, we saw projects like Solr, Lucene. They were also rules based, but they made this more effective. We could see some improvements in terms of how we indexed, in terms of the quality of search results. And the latest one that we have today for neural search is a framework called Genome. So that is based on neural search, it's not rules based. Now you might have heard me a lot in this video talking about rules and neural networks. So why exactly I'm talking about this, and let's see the difference when you implement search using rules based approach versus when you implement search system using neural network based approach. So first, remember that rules based approach is also called symbolic search. So I might use that keyword in this video. So let's talk about pros and cons. Pros of rules based approach is that it's faster retrieval, it's simple to execute, it is faster to retrieve the results, and then whatever results that we get using symbolic search, they are interpretable. We can reason about those results, that this is why we are getting these results. Now coming to neural search, what are the pros of neural search? Neural search is resilient to noise. So give it any type of data and it will figure out those features. As I said, it's all about input and output. It's the job of this neural search system to figure out those parameters, what's needed to accurately predict the outcome, the search results, the output. So it is resilient to noise. And then another pros of neural search is that it is easy to extend and scale. Same principle, because we are saying that input output is the only thing that matters. It is easy to extend. You want to implement a search system for English language, you have it. You want to implement for French, you have it. You don't need to do much work to do that. Simply just give more input, more output, that's it. So it's easy to extend and easy to scale, no domain experience required. Now what are the disadvantages of this neural search? Disadvantage is that it has less explainability. So what results are you getting using neural search? You don't know about those features. That's a black box. As we saw that it's a hidden layer, and you are getting results. You can say that this is the accuracy, are these results good for me or not, but how did we reach there? That's what we don't know. So there's a less explainability in neural search. And also another thing, disadvantage of neural search is that it needs lots of data to work. So you need to train it on lots of examples to give results accurately, and that's why you need lots of real world data to make it work. But having said that, there have been improvement in this space, like the solution I was talking to you, this open source project called Gina. It gives you pre-trained models, so you don't need to train. Rather, the trained models are already available and you can use them and just plug and play your data, and you have your search system ready. So these shortcomings have been covered by such open source system, open source softwares. Now what are the cons of a rules based approach? in rules-based approach, the system gets complex as you keep building your search experience, keep making it better. Your rules start to become complex, and in many cases you won't be able to achieve even the quality of the results as you would with neural search. Something that you might see on Google or any popular search engine that might not be easily replicable, but still people try to do that using a rules-based approach. And for that, what you need to do, you have to make complex logic, you have to add more rules, and it becomes tough to maintain this kind of software as we move forward. So this is one of the big disadvantages of rules-based approach. So going further, how we can solve it? And the answer is to use neural search and the combination of rules-based approach as well. So in many cases, you will find that rules-based approach is simpler to execute, although it is not giving that kind of experience that we would have wanted. But still, it is giving some results. At the same time, neural search, it will require some efforts, but it is giving us better results, plus it is scalable. So combine both of these approaches and you will have a great system for you, which gives a great search experience. And to get started with neural search, you can simply use projects such as Xena. And this is a framework to implement neural search. And you can build your own AI powered search using such software within just tens of lines of code. And you don't need to have a domain knowledge about machine learning or neural network. So it's quite easy to get started. If you have any question related to the topic, feel free to comment, feel free to reach me out. Thanks a lot and see you. Bye-bye.